Hey everyone, welcome back to our scenes. In today's video, we are going to talk about all the important questions from the second chapter, acid, bases and salt. So before getting started, let me remind you to subscribe to my channel and share my videos if you find them helpful. Okay, so starting with the first and the most important part, the diagrams. We have got two diagrams from this chapter. One is figure 2.1, reaction of zinc granules. This is the one, and second one is figure 2.3. yeah, this is the one, acid solution in water conducts electricity. So only two diagrams we have got over here. Next, see, from this chapter, acid, bases and salt, they have got lots of preparations, so around five preparations, and they are all in the form of paragraph, as you can see at the back and all. Like for example, this plaster of Paris, it starts somewhere from here and ends here. So in order to make things easier, I have just written the reaction and what you are actually referring to. So the first one here, sodium hydroxide, which is nothing but NaOH, it is produced by a process called chloroalkali process. So this is the chloroalkali process. You don't have a diagram for this. Then, so chloroalkali process is all about electricity, passing electricity through brine. Brine is nothing but sodium chloride solution. So it will break down and form NaCl, H2O and sodium hydroxide along with chlorine gas and a hydrogen gas. This is the reaction. Next, bleaching powder. This is the formula for bleaching powder. Again, what this this bleaching powder is produced from the chlorine, which is released during chloroalkali process here. Okay, so now here what will happen is calcium hydroxide or slaked lime will react with chlorine gas, which is first released during chloroalkali process, and in the course of the reaction, you're going to get bleaching powder along with water. Next one, baking soda in the list. So baking soda is nothing but sodium hydrogen carbonate. Here is your formula, and this is the reaction. You just need to remember the reaction. Okay, so sodium chloride, water, carbon dioxide and ammonia, when they all react together, you're going to get ammonium chloride along with baking soda. Next one, washing soda. Okay, so now regarding washing soda, you are getting questions like how can you produce or how can you prepare washing soda using baking soda or preparation of washing soda. Both are one and the same. You have to write the same one. And see here, for washing soda, you have got two reactions and you have to write both of them. So this is the washing soda reaction, chemical formula. So what you're supposed to do is you have to heat baking soda. When you heat baking soda, you're going to get sodium carbonate. See here, baking soda is being heated. This mark denotes heat. And you have got here sodium carbonate along with water and carbon dioxide. This is what is the side one. We don't need this. We just need this. So now further, you have to recrystallize it. Recrystallization, that is, we're going to take this and combine with a certain number of molecules of water. So it will form crystals of sodium carbonate, which is nothing but washing soda. Next, plaster of Paris, the last one. Okay, what we normally call as POP. So this is the formula for plaster of Paris, which is also known as calcium sulfate hemi, half, so hence hemi hydrate, calcium sulfate hemi hydrate. So now plaster of Paris, to get plaster of Paris, we need to heat gypsum at exactly 373 Kelvin. If it's not clearer, it's 373. And when you heat it, what will happen is it is going to lose water and result in plaster of Paris. As you can see here, we have got gypsum, and here is the heat which is being this calcium sulfate, sorry, gypsum is subjected to, and we are going to get here plaster of Paris along with 1.5 molecules of water being released. Okay, that's about your preparation. Next comes your uses. We have got uses in only this following four, that is bleaching powder, baking soda, washing soda and plaster of Paris. So see, if you're asking where it is, then see here in your textbook, after your chloroalkali process, see here, you have got use of bleaching powder, you have got use of baking soda, sorry, here baking soda, then washing soda on the next page, and also everything is easily mentioned in your textbook. You just need to byheart it as it is. Next, definitions. You don't have much of definitions over here. Only two, as far as I could find, water of crystallization. So regarding water of recrystallization, you have here. See, water of crystallization is a fixed number of water molecules present in one formula. Unit of a salt. Okay, so here. This is the definition from here to here. And it's on page number 32 of the state level book, part 1. Next, regarding pH levels, okay, so yeah, I have mentioned the pH levels of few of the important ones. These were asked, it can be asked in your objectives, or it can be asked in, you know, combination of 2 to 3 questions in your higher mark questions. Okay, so gastric juice, it is 1.2, lemon juice 2.2, pure water and blood, along with blood as well, so it's 7.4. rain water, this is the correct rainwater is 5.6, and if it is below 5.6, as you can see here, if it is less than 5.6, it is acid rain. Milk of magnesia is 10, sodium hydroxide is 14, since it's basic. Human body, our body works at around 7 to 7.8, whereas your tooth decay, when your tooth starts decaying, it is because when the pH level falls below 5.5, when it goes below 5.5, your tooth will start to decay. That's it. Next, table 2.3. See here. This is your table 2.3. I request you to go through this. See, they have given you the natural source and what kind of acid is present. Like, for example, vinegar, it's acetic acid. Orange contains citric acid, tamarind, tartaric acid, tomato, oxalic acid, your sour milk, that is nothing but your sour curd, lactic acid, lemon again, orange, lemon, all they contain, all the citric fruits. Citric acid and sting. When you add by the burning sensation which you get, it's because of methanoic acid. Nettle sting is also due to methanoic acid. So see here, methanoic acid is also known as formic acid. Okay, so in some of the questions, they don't mention methanoic acid in the, if at all it's asked in the objective, they might, instead of mentioning methanoic acid, they might write their formic acid. Formic, F-O-R-M-I-C, formic acid and methanoic acid, both are one and the same. Now, regarding textual questions, I request you to go through all the questions, all each and every one have their importance. So, see here, when you're going through it, please check that you are actually understanding everything and going through, because each and every one, they look same, but they are different from one another. Next, okay, this is an important part, indicators, which is not there in your textbook, and they might ask you questions related to this. So what are indicators? They are nothing but substances which change their color or smell when they are added in different substances based on acid or bases. Types, three types: natural, synthetic, olfactory. Natural are the natural ones. Synthetic is the artificial ones, whereas olfactory is the one which will give you a sense of smell. Okay, so now each one in detail, like natural indicators, we have got four. First one, litmus, the litmus paper which we use. So in acid, it's going to give you red color. In base, it's going to give you blue color. The red cabbage leaf extract, we are going to take the extract of the red cabbage leaf. In acid, it's going to give you red color. If you add it in acid solution, you will get red color. In base, if you add, it will give you green color. Then flowers of hydrangea plant. Okay, so here when you add the flower in acid, it's going to give you blue color. In base, it's going to give you pink color. Next, turmeric. This is the very easiest one. You can try this at home as well. So when you add it in acid, you're going to get no color change. It's going to be the same yellow color. When you add it in base, though, you're going to get a red color. Okay, a very beautiful red color will be seen. Now, next, synthetic indicators. You have got two here, phenolphthalein and methyl orange. Phenolphthalein will give you colorless solution, it will give you colorless liquid in acid, whereas pink color in a basic solution. Methyl orange, again, red in acid, whereas yellow in base. The last one are the olfactory. Olfactory are also all the natural indicators, but they give you a sense of smell instead of color. So all these three, onion, vanilla essence and clove oil, they're going to give you their own characteristic smell in acid solution. You know how the onion smells, you know how vanilla essence smell, you know how clove oil smell. So when you add it in something and if you're getting the smell, that means it is acidic in nature. And if you don't get their smell, then it is basic in nature. So that's it about your second chapter. Very soon I'll be coming with the rest of the chapters as well. So in the meantime, study well and do subscribe to my channel to get all the updates as soon as possible. Thank you.